Hello friends, in the last lecture we have discussed about the real and the pseudo forces, and in this lecture we would be discussing about the conservative and the non-conservative forces. So initially we will discuss about the conservative force. So what is a conservative force? Now we will consider one example. Now I have a stone, majha hatat ek dagad ahe, zaminivar thevlela ahe, it is on the floor. I have lifted it up. मी त्या दगडाला वरती उचललं. I have to do work for lifting the stone from the floor to this height. So its potential energy increases. Whatever जे काही कार्य मी त्या स्टोनवर केलं, whatever work is done by me on that stone is stored inside the stone as its potential energy. The stone is now at this height h. From the floor. So work is done by me on the stone. This work is stored as the potential energy of the stone. Now, if I drop the stone, now what is going to happen? Its kinetic energy is going to increase, but its potential energy is going to decrease by the same amount. And when it falls on the floor, again, its potential energy is the same as it was when the stone was lying on the floor before I lifted it at some height h. So when the stone is lifted from the floor, work is the earth is pulling the stone. When I am lifting the stone, the earth is pulling. So the work is done against the gravitational force. Work is done to lift the stone. The potential energy of the stone increases and it is stored inside the stone. Now, when the same stone is dropped, म्हणजे मी त्या स्टोनला मी हाताने सोडून दिला, then the earth, the stone is falling. The gravitational, in the direction of the gravitational pull, the potential energy which was stored in the stone decreases. It goes on decreasing, and when it is on the ground, जेव्हा तो जमिनीवर येतो, again त्याच्याकडे तेवढीच potential energy असते जेवढी मी जेव्हा त्याला जमिनीवरून उचलते आणि वर उचलते at height h, तेवढीच potential energy त्याच्याकडे उरते. So when the stone is lifted, the work is done against the gravitational force. And when the stone is falling down, the work is done in the direction of the gravitational force. Work done by the force or the work done against the force is independent of the path. Such force is called as conservative force. The work done by a force, or if the work done against a force, is independent of the actual path, the force is said to be a conservative force. Now, in this conservative force, the total energy, that is the kinetic energy plus the potential energy, is conserved. Now, the potential energy, now supposing I am lifting the stone. So, when I am lifting the stone, I am lifting it against the gravitational pull. Gravitational pull koncha direction madhe khalcha. It is pulling the stone in the downward direction. पण मला त्याच्या अपोज मध्ये कार्य करून आय हॅव टू वर्क अगेन्स्ट द ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स, ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल पुल, अँड आय हॅव टू लिफ्ट द स्टोन. सो दिस इज मायनस एफ, एफ अगेन्स्ट द ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स. सो दिस इज मायनस एफ इन टू डी एक्स, आय हॅव टू डिस्प्लेस द स्टोन. सो द पोटेन्शियल एनर्जी ऑफ द स्टोन इनक्रीजेस, दॅट इज डी यू. Minus F is because I am doing work against the gravitational force. Dx is the displacement of the stone. Now supposing, now here we have integrated, that is upon te steps ghetlele ahet from the floor to some height h, te apan sage integrate tay tyachya madhe ji potential energy increase hot geleli ahe pratyek step madhe ti apan integrate keli. So we write u is equal to minus, the integration ghetlela ahe pratyek dx 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 sathi. So integral of minus of f dx. So u is equal to minus of integral f dx. So this is the conservative force. Now, if when I'm lifting the stone from the floor, if friction or air resistance is present, then I have to do additional work. Now, if when I'm lifting the stone, if friction or air resistance is present, then additional work is necessary against the frictional force or the air resistance. This work is path dependent and not recoverable. Hence, when there are such forces like friction, air drag, the work done is not recoverable even if the path has changed. Such forces are non-conservative forces. The next point is the work done by a variable force. म्हणजे जो फोर्स व्हेरी होतो. नाव जो फोर्स व्हेरी होत नाही, जो फोर्स कॉन्स्टंट आहे, सेम आहे. आपण आत्तापर्यंत इन युअर इनिशियल इयर्स यू हॅव यूज्ड द फॉर्म्युला दॅट वर्क इज इक्वल टू फोर्स इन टू डिस्प्लेसमेंट. दिस फॉर्म्युला इज यूज्ड व्हेन द फोर्स इज ऑलवेज कॉन्स्टंट, इट इज नॉट चेंजिंग. सो वर्क डन इज फोर्स इन टू displacement. Or if this is the formula when the force and the displacement are in the same direction, but if the force is in this direction, that is the object is pulled, the force is applied in this direction but the object is moving in a force is applied in this direction but the object is displaced in this direction, it is the displacement is in at some angle theta. So the formula now for the work is W, which is a work, is the scalar quantity, is F dot ds. F, which is force, which is a vector quantity, and S, which is displacement, is a vector quantity, and the dot product of force and displacement. So W is equal to F dot ds, that is F into S into cosine of the angle between the force and the displacement. So this is the angle. We can write W is equal to F S cos theta. When the force is a constant force, or also W is equal to F S2 minus S1, where S2 minus S1 is S, that is the displacement. But if the force is not, the force is not a constant force, it is a variable force, it is a changing force. So like this, now this y-axis there is force and x-axis there is displacement from S1 to S2. The body is displaced, but not by the force of constant quantity. The force is variable quantity. So it is displaced in this way. Now, from point A to point B, the force is variable. So in such case, we use the integration. That is, now this is one strip where the force is constant. So F into ds. We can take another strip where the force is constant. We can take another strip where the force is constant. We can take another strip where the force is constant. So we can take all such strips where the force is remaining constant and we can add such strips. That is, we can integrate. So work is equal to integration from S1, displacement S1 to displacement S2. So from integral of S1 to S2, F dot ds. So work done when by non-linearly varying force. So this is non-linear varying force. So we integrate all such forces by the method of integration, and we use the formula integral of S1 to S2 F dot ds. Or if the work is done but the force is linearly varying force, so this is the linearly varying force from point A to point B, again we consider such strips where the force at the point remains constant, and we can integrate. We can add all the work done. म्हणजे आपण काय करायचं आहे, एक स्ट्रिप कन्सिडर करायची आहे जिथे फोर्स कॉन्स्टंट आहे. मग फोर वर्क डन इज फोर्स इन टू डिस्प्लेसमेंट फॉर दॅट स्ट्रिप. मग त्या स्ट्रिपसाठी फाईंड केलेलं वर्क, त्याच्यानंतर फोर्स चेंज झाला, इन्क्रीज झाला किंवा डिक्रीज झाला, मग त्या स्ट्रिपसाठी फाईंड केलेलं वर्क, म्हणजे वर्क डन इज इक्वल टू फोर्स इन टू डिस्प्लेसमेंट. तेवढ्या डिस्प्लेसमेंटसाठी वर्क फोर्स हा सेम आहे, फोर्स इज नॉट चेंजिंग फॉर दॅट व्हेरी व्हेरी स्मॉल डिस्प्लेसमेंट. Though it is non-linearly varying force or it is linearly varying force. So, ashe strips, what is this, the strip, what is the area of the strip? The area of the strip is the work done, because this is y-axis is force and x-axis is displacement. This y-axis is force and x-axis is displacement. So, the area of the strip is the work done, which is force into displacement, and such area all we add right from this point A to point B, and we get the work done by this non-linearly varying force, or here we get work done by this linearly varying force by this formula. Over a given region, a force in Newton varies as F equal to 3x square minus 2x plus 1. In this region, an object is displaced from x1 equal to 20 cm to x2 equal to 40 cm by the given force. Calculate the amount of work done. Given in the problem is a variable force, F, that is, which is changing. It is integral of 3x square minus 2x plus 1. So, where x1 is 20 cm and x2 is 40 cm. We have to find when the work done, when the displacement is from 20 cm to 40 cm. We have to find the work done. So we have the formula integral of s1 to s2 f dot ds, which is the work done by the variable force. Now, so integral. So 20 cm is 0.2 meter and 40 cm is 0.4 meter. So this is integral of 3x square minus 2x plus 1 dx. Now, according to the laws of integration from mathematics, we have integral of 3x square dx is, we take 3 common because 3 is constant, integral of x square dx. So the integration is, integration of x square dx is, the 3 is here, x to the power 2 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1. This is according to the formula. So this is 3 x cube upon 3. That is x cube is the integral of 3x square dx. Next is 2x dx. That is equal to 2. We take out. It is x dx. So the integral of x dx is x to the power 1 plus, this is 1. So x to the power 1 plus 1 upon 1 plus 1. So we get 2 x square upon 2, that is x square. And the integral of 1 dx is x. So now we substitute for this. We write the answer of each integration. We have, with the laws of integration, we have integrated and we have written x cube minus x square plus x, which is from 0.2 to 0.4, and we put up this, the upper limit 0.4 and the lower limit 0.2, and we get 0.4 cube minus 0.4 square plus 0.4 minus 0.2 cube minus 0.2 square plus 0.2, so we get work done is 0.304 minus 0.168, that is equal to 0.136 joules. Thank you.